Back here at home, a new storm is forecast to enter the Philippine area of responsibility this week. Pagasa forecaster Dan Villamil now joins us for an update. Dan?
Good afternoon, Sir Ron, and our televiewers here at ANC. So as of the moment, southwest monsoon or habagat is affecting the western sections of central and southern Luzon. For the next 24 hours here in Zambales, Bataan, Mimaropa, western Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms caused by the southwest monsoon. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting generally fair weather conditions apart from chances of isolated rain showers or localized thunderstorms, especially in the afternoon up until the evening. As of the moment, we're also monitoring an active tropical cyclone outside the Philippine area of responsibility. So as of 3 p.m. today, a tropical depression was located 1,565 kilometers east of extreme northern Luzon. It has maximum sustained winds of 45 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 55 kilometers per hour. It is currently moving south-southwestward at 10 kilometers per hour. As of the moment, we are not expecting any direct effect of this tropical cyclone on any part of our country. And that will be all for the weather update for today. This is Dan Villamil reporting.
Dan, just one question. When can we expect that weather disturbance to possibly enter the Philippine area of responsibility?
At the moment, we are currently looking at two scenarios for this tropical cyclone. So the first scenario is that this tropical depression will move generally in a southwestward direction and may enter our area of responsibility by Thursday or Friday. And the second scenario that we're looking at is that this tropical cyclone will remain almost stationary and move northward in a generally northward direction away from our country. And in both of these scenarios, the tropical cyclone will have no direct effect whatsoever on any part of our country.
Thanks for the forecast, Dan Villamil, Pagasa. Here at home, an infectious diseases expert opposes a possible lifting or relaxing of the face mask mandate, arguing it may send a dangerous message to the public. This comes as government still lags behind its booster jab targets. Let's get details now. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Pia Gutierrez. Hi, Pia.
Hi, Ron. Yes, that's right. Infectious diseases expert Dr. Ron Jean Solante warns that the Cebu City LGU's order lifting or relaxing the mandatory wearing of face masks in public places could send a wrong message to the public that the country is no longer at risk for COVID-19 and could potentially discourage more people from getting their booster shots against the virus. In an interview this morning, Solante reminded the public that it is not yet time to lift face mask rules, citing the continuing community transmission of COVID-19 and the country's low booster uptake. Solante is concerned that people would see Cebu City's order as a signal that they can already safely disregard minimum public health standards and that they no longer need to get vaccinated or boosted against the disease. He said that the country should still not lower its guards or be complacent against or amid the ongoing pandemic so as not to endanger those belonging to the vulnerable population who are especially at risk for severe COVID-19 or death. He also urges LGUs to coordinate with the health department and their local experts before implementing drastic policies that involve the protection of the public against COVID-19. In the same interview, Solante talked about Legionnaire's disease, which has been identified as the cause of a cluster of pneumonia cases in Argentina. The infectious diseases expert says the disease is caused by the Legionella bacteria, which usually thrives in water or ventilation systems of buildings. It can also thrive in hot tubs, pools, or even air conditioning systems, and is usually spread through water droplets in the air. Those who are exposed to the bacteria may develop Legionnaire's disease, but individuals of advanced age or with comorbidities or the immunocompromised becoming more vulnerable for severe infection. Among the symptoms are cough, fever, body pains, and pneumonia. He says what happened in Argentina can very well happen here in the Philippines, so he advises the public to keep their water systems clean as part of efforts to prevent the disease. Ron?
That story from Pia Gutierrez. Thanks, Pia.
Drug regulators in China have approved the world's first inhalable COVID vaccine. The needle-free vaccine, made by Tianjin-based CanSino Biologics, will be used as a booster shot. There is no publicly available verified or peer-reviewed data on the efficacy of CanSino's vaccine. But the company says it can effectively induce comprehensive immune protection against the virus after just one breath. The approval comes as China sees a recent flare-up in COVID outbreaks. The country has so far administered over 3.4 billion COVID shots, according to its health commission.